president is entangled in still another fight on another front, and this time, Republicans. Let's face it, Republicans and President Obama, they hate each other, and the fight is fierce. The president's critics say he's lawless and trying to unconstitutionally grab power. The president fighting back, threatening to use a pen to stomp all over Congress and the Republicans.
Republicans aren't cooperating, so the president has to go the executive order route.
I've got a pen, and I've got a phone, and I can use that pen to sign executive orders.
On my own, I'm going to act on my own. I'll act on my own.
I would remind the president he also has a constitution.
That of all of the dismaying aspects of the Obama presidency, perhaps the most dangerous is this consistent pattern of lawlessness.
Is the president, when he says that, is he saying that he's going to be going around Congress?
The president's made clear that he will work with Congress where Congress is willing to work with him.
Republicans, obstructionists because of Fox News and Limbaugh. And this, then, leaves our poor young president with no choice but then to violate the Constitution.
Congressman Trey Gowdy joins us. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. How are you?
I'm very well. Do you agree with Speaker Boehner that the president is essentially overstepping the Constitution? Because Speaker Boehner says that the president also has a Constitution and an oath of office he took when he swore to faithfully execute the laws of this country. Is that your thought about the president, or is the Speaker wrong?
Well, there are several instances that buttress Speaker Boehner's position, including the Supreme Court. He's going to lose on the HHS mandate. He's going to lose on recess appointments. He lost 9-0 in a religious liberty case called Hosanna-Tabor. You know, Greta, my perspective is this. He says he has a phone and a pen. I would tell him to be careful using the phone. This day and age, you never know who's going to be listening in on the conversation. But he's had a phone and a pen for 5 years. And we have an anemic economy, a feckless foreign policy, and people are losing hope. So rather than accept responsibility, he wants to blame Congress. That's what he means by this, is I'm going to blame Congress. They're recalcitrant. They won't work with me. He's had half a decade, and here we sit.
Now, his press secretary said that the president wants to work with Congress. And, of course, the president says that he has a phone. Do you see any indication that the president wants to work with Congress? Is that a fair statement by the press secretary or not?
No, ma'am, it is not. Jay Carney can't cite a single solitary example where this administration has wanted to work in good faith with House Republicans. Now, from 2008 to 2010, they didn't have to deal with us. They had all the gears of government, and they gave us Obamacare. When the president has the cards, he calls the bet. When he doesn't have the cards, he blames Bush, tsunamis, hurricanes, Fox News, racial animus, everyone but himself. And now, because he wants to retake the House and keep the Senate, it's probably popular to blame House Republicans. I might do the same thing if I were in his shoes. Or the other alternative is just to accept responsibility for the last 5 years on immigration, on mandatory minimum sentences. There are areas, mental health with respect to access to firearms, there are areas we're happy to work with him. But Greta, honestly, he doesn't have an interest in working with us. He wants to work with Speaker Pelosi, not Speaker Boehner, and that requires them to win in November and us to lose. And that's what all of this is about.
Is there any overgesture from the White House, from the president, to the House of Representatives, to the Republicans, even sort of like, let's talk, or he uses that phone? Is there any overt gesture at all in the last 6 months?
In his defense, he did come to talk to us. It was probably about a year ago. And frankly, he didn't have to. He came to the Capitol and talked to us. But there's a level of distrust, in part because we do believe this, his overarching goal is for John Boehner to be the minority leader. So when you look at it from the standpoint that he wants to keep the Senate and retake the House, I mean, does he really have the country's best interest in mind? He certainly doesn't have the Republican Party's best interest in mind. He's had 5 years. We have a bad economy, a bad foreign policy, and people are losing hope. And he's going to lose in November unless he can find a scapegoat. And he's tried natural disasters, and he's tried Fox News, and he's tried everything except himself, and now he's going to try House Republicans. But no, he doesn't. cite me an example of where he has picked up the phone and said, you know what, I want to give a little bit. On this issue, I'm going to give a little bit. When he asked the cards, look at last October. We asked for a delay in Obamacare, which God knows now we needed. Everybody concedes we needed. He wouldn't even discuss that because he didn't have to.
Congressman, thank you. Always nice to see you, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Have a good weekend.